cannot turn the job over to anyone else. If the United States fails, then the whole cause of freedom fails.
Willie Mays is looking for his 534th home run. A telling demonstration of Castro's sway.
It's an amazing new wireless wizard remote.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you. My brain still remains within the sound of silence. In restless dreams, I
silence. Tonight we'll be telling you the stories and singing you the songs of both Paul Simon and, of course, Mr. Art Garfunkel.
Now, to begin with, we're going back to the start of their story, which begins in Queens, New York, 1941. Both Paul and Art were born in the same year, only a few weeks apart and only a few blocks away from each other. They both attended the same school, and they met while performing in the school play Alice in Wonderland. Paul was the White Rabbit, and Art was the Cheshire Cat. Paul and Art became best friends, and they found something they both loved, music.
In fact, their first love was rock and roll, and the pair would spend hours listening to Elvis Presley, Little Richard, and of course, their all-time favorites, the Everly Brothers.
In fact, they loved the Everly Brothers so much that before they became Simon and Garfunkel, they started off their musical career as a fairly successful rock and roll double act known as Tom and Jerry. This was their biggest hit, Hey School Girl.
And as Hey School Girl came out in the chaos of the 1950s rock and roll scene, in that fashion, we are going to ask for some audience participation. And don't worry, it's very easy. All you have to do is clap along with our drummer Harry.
During the early 60s, the mood was changing across America, and the tide was running strongly in favour of the youth. Social turbulence at home and the widely reported conflict in Vietnam gave rise to a more emotional and intellectual songwriter, with one young scruffy songwriter claiming that the times, they are a-changing, and a hard rain's gonna fall. Both Paul and Art shared a passion for this growing trend in folk music, which was sweeping across America, so they decided to sing together again, this time using their real names as Simon and Garfunkel. In the fall of 64, they released their album Wednesday Morning 3 AM. They were performing around the folk clubs of Greenwich Village, New York, as a duo, just one guitar and two voices, singing in harmony.
Sadly, Wednesday Morning 3 AM didn't do as well as they hoped, and shortly after, inspired by the folk music that he heard coming across the Atlantic, Paul decided to move to England to tour as a solo artist, performing in the many small pubs and folk clubs around the country. His payment would often be as simple as a bed, or even a sofa to sleep on for the night.
Art decided to stay in New York and study for a PhD. He enrolled back into college, embracing poetry, literature, and art. He visited Paul a couple of times in England, and they would often appear on stage together, giving them both a chance to play and harmonize along to Paul's new material.
Time hurries on, and the leaves die. is filled with the love of a girl. I held her close, but she faded in the night, like a poem I meant to write, and the leaves that are green turned brown, and they wither with the wind, and they crumble in your
guitar in hand, Paul performed all across England, travelling mostly by train. By this point, he'd written enough songs to head to London to record his first solo album, the Paul Simon Songbook. He also met and fell in love with a young Welsh girl named Kathy Chittick. Now, we can only assume he wrote this next song for her, as he called it Kathy's Song.
Words that tear and strain to rise. And so you see, I have come to doubt all that I once held is true. I stand alone without beliefs. The only truth I know is you. And as I watch the drops of rain weave their weary paths and die, I know that I am like the rain there before the grace of you go by.
Thank you very much. Now, while Paul was over in England, a little-known radio DJ from Cocoa Beach, Florida, started to give their song, The Sound of Silence, some serious airtime. So much, in fact, that it went to number one in the US charts. So Paul had a big decision to make, whether to stay in England performing as a solo artist, or to go back to America, back to his best friend Artie, and to go back into the studio. Winter's day in a deep and dark December. I am alone, gazing from my window to the streets below on a freshly fallen silent shroud of snow. Friendship causes pain, it's laughter and it's loving my disdain. I am a rock, I am an island. Don't talk of love when I've heard the word before. Yeah. Franco's best buddy Artie, and they went into the studio and recorded the album, The Sounds of Silence.
Now, what Paul didn't realise was that the producer, Tom Wilson, had dubbed a live electric band over the top of the original acoustic recording of the song The Sound of Silence, trying to emulate bands such as The Byrds. He had just produced the song Like a Rolling Stone for Bob Dylan.
A number of the songs on The Sounds of Silence were actually originally written and recorded in England as solo songs, and those versions can be heard on the Paul Simon songbook.
Now, this next song is based on an old poem by Edwin Arlington Robinson, and in Paul Simon's own unique writing style, is, well, actually a rather happy song about suicide.
Thank you.
1967, and went on to sell over 1 million records.
Now, at this time, Simon and Garfunkel were, experimenting with the psychedelia of the 1960s, and that started to be reflected within their work, no more so than this next song, Patterns. Like the pieces of a puzzle.
darkness I must dwell. Like the color of my skin,
or the day that I grow.
My life is made of patterns that seem to scarcely be controlled.
They were not only just touring America, but all over the world. The sheer volume of touring and recording meant that they were working more and more, and spending time as friends less and less.
What a dream I had, pressed in Oregon. Smoky burgundy, softer than the rain. I wandered empty streets down past the sharp displays. I heard cathedral bells tripping down the alleyways as I walked.
Tonight I'll sing my songs again, I'll play
like emptiness and harmony. I need someone to comfort me.
Because in the next act, we perform songs from the two biggest albums, Bookends and Bridge Over Troubled Water. Now, this next song is an adaptation of an old English folk song, and it's called Scarborough Fair.
I was so hard to believe. I can't hear you just for the last 2-3 months. Oh, yes. And I maintain stronger to this event. I don't think it's an ordinary cold.
Wish I was an English muffin, about to
make the most out of a toaster. I ease myself down, coming up brown. No, I prefer boys and dirty more than any ordinary jam. I'm citizens for boys and dirty jam fan. If I become a first lieutenant, would you put my photo on your piano?
Some real estate here in my life. ladies and gentlemen, on bass, Mr. Nick Martin.
Relationship was stretched to near breaking point. It was only made worse by art interests in movies and acting. However, they went into the studio to record what would become their greatest ever masterpiece, their album Bridge Over Troubled Water.
We are now going to do some of the songs from Bridge Over Troubled Water, starting with this one, which was conceived while the pair were living in their newly adopted home of Los Angeles, California, where Art was working on the movie Catch 22. They were socializing with some friends when they started to make this rhythmic pattern on whatever they had lying around. Pots and pans, tables and chairs. They liked what they were hearing so much, they put up some microphones to capture the sound, and they took that into the studio and used it as the rhythm track on this next song.
Well, that's all well and good, but we thought we could do one better. We thought we could get a room full of people here in Kalmar. You could be that rhythm track for us. It's very simple. All you have to do is clap along with it.
Thank you very much. Now, Bridge Over Troubled Water was the biggest selling album of 1970, 1971, and 1972. At the time, it was the biggest selling album of all time, which is pretty incredible when you think of all the Elvis and the Beatles records that came right before it. Simon and Garfunkel were at the height of their fame.
Sadly, it was in 1970 that Simon and Garfunkel decided to split up. Why? Well, there were lots of reasons. Hall and Art were best friends from school, and they'd had a rollercoaster of a relationship. But the pure exhaustion that followed the huge success of their album, Bridge Over Troubled Water, meant that they felt they were moving in different directions and could no longer work together. Paul wrote this next song for his good friend Art, with a nod to their days as Tom and Jerry.
Tom, get your playwright on time. I know that your part will go fine. Fly down to Mexico. pretend I'm gonna get that girl no matter what I do.
When Simon and Garfunkel used to perform live, they would often end with a song by their all-time favourites, the Everly Brothers. So in that tradition, we are going to leave you with this next song. But before we go, we just want to say thank you so much for coming out tonight. We've had an absolute blast up here, and we hope you have as well. Thank you so much.
Bye. Pleasure to let you know that we are on social media. We have a Facebook page and an Instagram page, which is at the Simon Garfunkel Story. We also have a website with all of our dates on there. They're all really good ways of keeping in touch and seeing where in the world we are.
But before we leave you tonight, please enjoy one last song with us.
just a poor boy, but my story seldom told. I've squandered my resistance for a pocket full of mumbles, such are promises. All lies and jest, still the man hears what he wants to hear and disregards the rest.
Boxer, and a fighter by his trade.